Welcome aboard, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and that's right, everybody in between. The Ranger Hockey right here on Lakes Area Community Television. It is a glorious Tuesday, January 24th, 2017. Welcome to Litch Heidel Arena, located right here in the heart of the Forest Lake Sports Center for game number 17. This is a non-conference matchup. Forest Lake with, we'll start with the Suburban East Conference record, 3-5-1, an overall record of 4-10-2. Cloquet Esco, part of the Lake Superior Conference, and they are 3-0 in conference play, overall record of 8-5-2. Game number 17 for your Rangers, game number 16 for the visitors. Forest Lake struggling here at Litch Heidel Arena this season. 2-6 at home. The Lumberjacks of Cloquet, 4-4-1 on the road this season. They're coming off of a 5-1 win on the road against Duluth Denfeld. Puck has been dropped. Game number 17 officially underway here at Litch Heidel Arena. Thank you for tuning in again. You're watching Tuesday Night Ranger Hockey here on Lakes Area Community Television. In net for your Rangers, number 41, Brady Peterson. Forest Lake in their traditional home white with a splash of maroon and gold. The visitors in blue and yellow. That one will be coming back. We'll have an icing here with 50 seconds removed from period number one. Ziraki will take the draw for his Rangers inside of the Lumberjack zone. Both Ziraki and Bez putting in work. Actually, that is number 27, Anderson for Forest Lake. Lumberjacks able to clear. Quite a hit put on by Ziraki along the near side boards. Cycled back inside of the Cloquet zone. Anderson on the attack. Play picked up inside of the neutral zone. Forest Lake forced to regroup. Gutterman with possession as he's checked off of the play. Runs into Smith. Fortunately for Forest Lake, catastrophe avoided with the defenders running into each other. Gutterman receives a pass from Smith. Forest Lake struggling to clear here early in period number one. That's dumped back into Ranger territory. Turned over. Here's an opportunity for the Lumberjacks, and that shot misses. White wide to the right. Dumped back into the Forest Lake zone. Nice hit put on in the corner by number 5, Kemplin. with that touch. That's another icing that will come back into the Forest Lake zone. Face off won by Robbie. Let's see if Forest Lake can get to work here. Picked up behind Peterson, currently tied up. Carried out by Cloquet. Played by Kemplin, turned over inside the Rangers zone. Lumberjacks go tape to tape at the blue line, and there is another save by Peterson. We'll have a faceoff inside the Forest Lake zone. 0-0 is the score. Soraki in the faceoff circle for your maroon and gold. Pass to Anderson is deflected. Picked up by Soraki as that is dumped into the Lumberjack zone. We've got a whistle here on the ice. Let's see what this is. It's like nothing more than the net coming off of its pegs. Rangers will make a last minute change. Robbie will take the face off. That's sent around near side. Okay, able to clear, but puck is turned over inside of the neutral zone. Times two as Forest Lake unable to corral it. Nice move by Saltness. Rangers with numbers. Thrown out front. That is deflected. And again, deflected inside of the neutral zone. That will be dumped into Ranger territory. Give and go as the Rangers will advance into the Lumberjack zone. The official almost getting blasted along the near side boards there. That's dumped into the Forest Lake zone. Icing waved off. Rangers forced to play the puck. Still looking for their first shot on net here early in period number one. Cloquet with three. Obviously, this is a non-conference match here tonight, as you very well know. Forest Lake in the Suburban East Conference. Cloquet, part of the Lake Superior Conference. Okay, we'll attempt to throw it out front, but nobody home for them, and that was stolen anyways by Soraki. And it looks like we may have an offsides, or maybe not. We may have a 2-minute minor being handed out here. It's like a trip or hook on somebody. Well, we're lining up the faceoff inside the Cloquet zone, so looks like your Rangers will be on the power play. Faceoff won by the blue and gold. Dumped in by Gutterman, picked up along the near side boards. Okay, looking to, and they do clear deep into Ranger territory. Just over 11 minutes left to go here in period number one. Saltness to Gutterman, and that pass intercepted. It looks like number 47, Blake Gutterman, may be heading to the box. Indeed he is. That will void the power play. We're going to have some four-on-four hockey here. Face-off won by Forest Lake. Play picked up inside of the neutral zone. Eventually trickles in to the zone of Cloquet. They advance to neutral ice. That puck pulled out of midair. That wasn't the part that was so impressive. It was the fact that he was able to pull it out of midair and still slide that puck across like a regular pass. I don't think the forward for Cloquet was expecting such an accurate pass. And honestly, he just wasn't ready with the stick on his eye, or the stick on the ice. Four hockey has definitely opened up the ice here at Lichheidel Arena. Let's see if speedy Forest Lake Rangers can take advantage of this. Perhaps take a one goal lead here to open up the game at home. Forest Lake struggling here on home ice this year so far with a record of 2-6. Forest Lake would obviously like to improve on that. Saved by Peterson, rebound kicked into the corner, back to the blue line, where the Lumberjacks will go tape to tape. There's another shot on net. Corralled by the Lumberjacks, back to the blue line. That shot, looking for a tip, will go untouched into the corner. Recovered by the Lumberjacks, another shot from the blue line. That's off of the back of Mogren. One-time opportunity. Puck still sitting there untouched. One of the Rangers finally able to get a stick on it. There's another dangerous opportunity for the visitors. Plenty of scoring chances here early in period number one, especially with four-on-four hockey. That's dumped into the Ranger zone by number 24, Trevor Inman, 6 foot junior for Cloquet. Fink with a shot. Dangerous area to take it to. Puck gets kicked back to the blue line. Shot taken by number 28. That is Dane Stayanoff of the Lumberjacks. That misses wide left. Scoring opportunity for the visiting blue and gold. Number 6 tied up by Smith behind goaltender Peterson. Forest Lake should be able to clear. They do, however. Cloquet able to recover and will regroup deep inside of Lumberjack territory. Still a scoreless game here midway through period number one. You're watching Tuesday Night Ranger Hockey right here on the one and only Lakes Area Community Television. I am Thomas Glenn, your voice to everything Forest Lake sports related, whether you like it or not. Okay, we'll advance out of the neutral zone, and what a goal. Number 24, Trevor Inman, goes top shelf, opposite side. Can't do much with that. Didn't have a lot of room to work with, but all it's a pretty nice puck placement. Visitors with a one-goal lead here in period number one. Okay, with possession back inside of the Forest Lake zone. That's picked up by Mogren along the near side board, sent far side. Another shot taken from the blue line of Cloquet. Another one. Pad saved by Peterson, and he is facing quite a few shots here early on. A little bit more than you'd like your goaltender to see here in the starting period. But Forest Lake trying to piece together something here, and look at that. The Rangers have just tied it up. With that deflected pass out front, Rangers capitalize and respond. We are locked up at one apiece here in period number one. That goal coming at 12:35 in period number one. Scoring for your Rangers, number 15, junior Dylan Fink, with another goal on the season for him. Guterman with possession. Cross ice pass off of the stick of Robbie, and that's deflected back into Ranger territory, chased down by Miller. Dumped into the Lumberjack zone. Forest Lake back on the attack. Turnover inside of the neutral zone. Forest Lake with an opportunity here. And look at that, the initial save is made. Goaltender out of place, the puck in the right spot. And let's see who they're going to credit that with. I believe it was Anderson. But at any rate, your Rangers have just taken a one-goal lead with 4:19 remaining here in period number one. Waiting for the official confirmation. Played by Peterson Kemplin. That is correct. Goal number two has been credited to number 27, junior Wyatt Anderson. Pretty good turnout here at Lichtenfels Arena tonight for game number 17. That is dumped into Ranger territory. Icing waved off. Forest Lake forced to play it. Tied up behind Peterson. Doesn't seem to be going anywhere. It does pop free. Shot taken by number two, Andy Akers. Held in for Cloquet by number 24, Trevor Inman. Inman with a goal here early tonight. Oh. dumped into the force leg zone. Cloquet will head to the bench to get some fresh legs out here on the ice. Anderson taking a stick to the mask. That could have been a number of penalties that went uncalled. And, oh, wow. Rangers dodging a huge bullet there. Miscommunication almost resulting in friendly fire. Again, held in at the blue line. Force Lake able to clear. Lumberjacks with possession carried out of the neutral zone. That's turned over, and here come your Rangers with a one-goal lead. Robbie out front. Not even needed. Look at this. Forest Lake putting up three goals here in the first period. Looks like scoring for Forest Lake, number 21, Dalton Saltness, had Robbie in front if he needed him. But he liked the angle, took the shot, and he reached the back of the net. To number 21, sophomore Dalton Saltness. That is three unanswered goals here for your Rangers in period number one. Forest Lake with a two-goal lead. Played by Gutterman, that's sent around far side boards, held in at the blue line. Anderson checked off of the play. Turnover in the Forest Lake zone. Shot just wide of Peterson. And now Cloquet will head to the bench to make a change that will allow Forest Lake a little bit of time and space. Gutterman on the rush has his pockets picked. Turned over inside of the neutral zone. Cloquet back on the attack, trying to respond. That was a dangerous deflection. That almost ended up in the back of the net. Heads up play by Peterson as that puck changed direction quite quickly. Again, held in at the blue line by number 21 for Cloquet, and we have less than a minute left to go here in period number one. We're going to have an ice, and that faceoff will be coming back into Ranger territory. Forest Lake with just five shots on net. Three of them have reached the back of the net. That's the bottom line. Not a very good save percentage for our visiting goaltender, however. Are hearing no complaints from you. Mogren taken down inside of the neutral zone. Let's see if this is going to warrant a penalty or if that was just an offsides call, and that's what it looks like it is. Face off just outside the Forest Lake zone. You at home are going to have to determine who won that face off. Dumped back into the Rangers zone, picked up by Best. Checked off of the play. Picked up by number 16, Brendan Durand. Shoot. And with the buzzer, that will do it for period number one. You can hear Ranger Nation. They are extremely happy. Forest Lake, 3. Cloquet, 1. Don't go anywhere. Plenty more hockey. left to come right here on Lakes Area Community Television.
Patriotism. There's a word thrown around a lot. It inspires passionate debate and is worn like a badge of honor, and with good reason, because it means love and devotion for one's country. Love. For a word designed to unite, it can also be pretty divisive. You see, there's more to patriotism than flag sequined onesies and rodeos and quadruple cheeseburgers. Patriotism is love for a country, not just pride in it. But what really makes up this country of ours? What is it we love? It's more than just a huge rock full of animals like cougars and eagles, right? It's the people. Do me a favor. Close your eyes for a second. I want to try something out. Picture the average U.S. citizen. Think about it. How old are they? What's their hair like? How much can they bench? You got one? Okay. So chances are, the person you're picturing right now looks a little different than the real average American. There are 319 million U.S. citizens. 51% are female. So first off, the average American is a woman. Cool, huh? Is that what you pictured? 54 million are Latino, 40 million senior citizens, 27 million are disabled, 18 million are Asian. That's more people in the U.S. than play football and baseball combined. 9 million are lesbian, gay, bi, transgender, more than the entire amount of people that live in the state of Virginia. Around 10 million are redhead, 5.1 million play ultimate frisbee, and 3.5 million are Muslim. Triple the number of people currently serving in the United States military. Almost half the country belongs to minority groups. People who are lesbian, African American, and bi, and transgender, and Native American, and proud of it. We know that labels don't devalue us, they help define us, keeping us dialed into our cultures and our beliefs and who we are as Americans. After all, what's more American than freedom to celebrate the things that make us, us? I mean, it's stitched into the stars and stripes of this country. From the Constitution to Gettysburg, to our motto, E Pluribus Unum, from many, one. It's even in our country's name, the United States. This year, patriotism shouldn't just be about pride of country. It should be about love, love beyond age, disability, sexuality, race, religion, and any other labels. Because the second any of us judge people based on those labels, we're not really being patriotic, are we? So let's try this one more time. Close your eyes. Picture the average Joe or Joan or Juan or Jean-Luc. The real people will make America, America. And this year, whenever you feel the urge to don those star-spangled shorts, set off fireworks the size of my biceps to show love for our country, remember that to love America is to love all Americans. Because love has no labels.
Welcome back, Lakes Area Community Television. Ranger hockey here on this Tuesday, January 24th. Forks Lake putting up a three spot in period number one to take a two-goal lead over the visiting Cloquet Lumberjacks. Forks Lake giving up goal number one and then responding with three unanswered goals to finish out period number one. Scoring for the Rangers in the first, number 15, Dylan Fink, Dalton Saltness, and number 27, Wyatt Anderson, all responsible for a goal up there on the scoreboard here at Lechina Arena. Period number two officially underway. Robbie with the shot on net. That's kicked into the corner. Forks Lake now with six shots on net. Three in which crossed the plane for a goal. Keep on shooting for Slate, because right now the goaltender is only stopping half the shots. Lumberjacks with possession inside of the Forest Lake zone, tied up by Saltness in the high slot area. Initial save made by Peterson. Forest Lake now with possession inside of the neutral zone, carried in by Fink. Poke checked off of his stick. Forest Lake unable to hold the zone. And we'll have a whistle here early in period number two. Forest Lake 3, Cloquet 1. Just a simple offsides. We'll have a faceoff just outside of the Cloquet zone here. Soraki in the faceoff circle for your maroon and gold. Won by the Rangers. Forest Lake will be forced to regroup deep in Ranger territory. They will advance in a neutral play. Turned over, Lumberjacks. Give it up inside of the neutral zone. That's dumped back into the Cloquet zone. Just under 2 minutes removed here from period number two. And we may have a penalty. Yes, indeedy. Rangers on the PK. Faceoff won by the Lumberjacks. They do hold the zone. Yeah. That shot deflected well into the rafters. Again, Lumberjacks on the power play. This is power play opportunity number one. 2 minute minor being assessed to, I don't know who. Somebody at Forest Lake, and it was holding, I can tell you that much. Gutterman putting in work down in the corner along the near side boards. Carries it around to the far side, picked up by Saltness, cycled back to Gutterman as the Rangers look to clear. Wraparound attempt is foiled. Solid performance here from Peterson thus far. Robbie now with possession. Shorthanded opportunity for Forest Lake. That gets foiled as well. They do take some time off of the PK. And now we've got a whistle on the ice. Looks like the power play for the Lumberjacks just been voided. 4-on-4 hockey with a 2 minute minor being assessed to number 15, Landon Langenbrunner of Cloquet. So plenty of ice out there to work with. Bring in the speed. Rangers with a 2-goal lead. Carried into neutral play by number 17, Drake Best. Twenty-seven seconds left to go in the Ranger penalty. And Cloquet will respond. That is not a power play goal. That was even strength 4-on-4 hockey. Forest Lake 3, Cloquet 2. Lumberjacks with possession inside the Force Lake zone. There's another shot on net. Looking for the one-timer out front to number five, and that is broken up by one of the Force Lake defenders. Puck still in the Force Lake zone, currently tied up along the far side boards, carried around near side. This should allow Force Lake a little bit of room, and that's dumped into the Lumberjack zone. Anderson putting in work down in the corner. Back to the blue line. Anderson forced to use the backhand. Unfortunately, not able to get everything he wanted to on that shot. There was some open net there, but just could not get to it. Faceoff coming inside. The Cloquet. Wait. Are they moving the. Nope, never mind. I was right. Faceoff will be held inside the Cloquet zone. Faceoff won by the visitors. That's sent around near side. That's either got to be offsides or I have no idea what's going on. Yep. Robbie wins the faceoff for his Rangers, immediately dumped into the Lumberjack zone. Played along the near side boards. Thrown out front to Robbie. And that will reach the back of the net, courtesy of a five-hole backhander in Force Lake. Wow. This is a Force Lake Ranger hockey team that has had issues here in the 2016-17 regular season with offense, but four goals up there on the scoreboard in the first 23 minutes of play. Not bad. Not bad at all. Rangers reclaim that two-goal lead. Odd man rush by the Lumberjack, saved by Peterson. Cloquet able to hold the zone. That's sent into the corner along the far side. Thrown out front, deflected back to the blue line. Cloquet able to hold. That shot's deflected. Again, back to the blue line. This time the Lumberjacks are unable to hold. That's played off of the near side boards, picked up inside of the neutral zone. Play broken up by Gutterman. Thrown out front. Miller for Force Lake. That is flipped off of the glass and will slide its way all the way down into Lumberjack territory for an icing. That faceoff will be coming back into Ranger zone. Soraki to take the draw for his Rangers. I think that faceoff will go to the skates. I don't know whose, but somebody's. Dumped in by Bartholomew. Lumberjacks with possession inside of the neutral zone, thrown out front. Pull checked away by Peterson. Gutterman nearly takes the head off the official with that backhander. That was a little premature, I'd say. It looked like Forest Lake clearly going to win the race. Anderson, and what, are they going to give him a penalty for it? Did he get a two-minute minor for skating too fast? Cloquet power play back at it. Trailing by two. Number 27, Wyatt Anderson. Boy, they got to work on that audio system here at La Chitl Arena. Some days you can, it's as clear as a bell, but most days, I mean, it is distorted and you cannot understand a thing that is said. Okay, like I said, back on the power play, they have one power play goal already, trailing by two goals here in period number two. A little give and go, point blank. Tape to tape at the blue line. Number 13 open, Forest Lake able to get a stick on it, and that is just enough to break it up. That clear will take a good at least 15, 16, 17 seconds off of the penalty kill. Tough angled shot will sail over the head of Peterson. Cloquet able to hold the zone just briefly as Anderson will break that up. Sent back into Ranger territory, played by Peterson. And that alone will allow Forest Lake to dump it back into Lumberjack territory. That took another 20 seconds off of the PK. Challenged by Soraki along the near side. Now behind Peterson, Forest Lake will clear. And the power play has expired for the visitors. Forest Lake back to full strength. Picked up inside of the neutral zone. Forest Lake now forced to regroup in Ranger territory / neutral play. Sent around near side, played by Saltness. Saltness with a goal here in period number one. Opportunity in the works. Covered up by the Cloquet goaltender, will have a face-off inside the Lumberjack zone. Again, it is a Tuesday, January 24th. Forest Lake hosting non-conference Cloquet Esco Carlton. Mogren in the face-off circle for your Rangers. What a glorious face-off it was. One by Forest Lake back to the blue line. Now played in the near side corner. Mogren putting in work as well as Miller. Zalwin, my bad. Nearly turned over in the offensive zone. Flipped the script and now Cloquet with possession inside Ranger territory. Sent upstream, but that's held in, and Cloquet will capitalize. Forest Lake caught, I hate to say it, but a little off guard there. And now, lead by one. Forest Lake 4, Cloquet 3. We have got ourselves a hockey game here tonight. Face-off won by the Lumberjacks, carried back into Ranger territory. Thrown out front, poke checked away by Peterson. And after putting one in, they are threatening and threatening well in front of that fourth leg net. Peterson able to come up with saves 1 through 5, and that's where it will be covered up. Faceoff inside the fourth leg zone. Touché Peterson. Faceoff won by your maroon and gold. That's sent up at the, or played off of the near side boards. Deflected back into the fourth leg zone. Cloquet back on the attack. Not for long. That's broken up. Forest Lake with possession inside the Cloquet zone. Turned over. And here come the Lumberjacks. That is broken up by Gutterman. Oh. You have got to be kidding me. Possession was lost. Not really... Can't really blame anybody. It's just one of those freak things that happen in the game of hockey. And in the process of looking for the puck, Gutterman got caught up in his skates as he turned around to pivot. Puck went with the skate and ended up right on the stick of one of the forwards for Cloquet. And that's all she wrote. Point blank shot. Here we are, locked up at 4 apiece here in period number 2. That will most definitely be coming back. That's icing on Cloquet. No short supply of goals here at Litchitel Arena here tonight, that's for sure. Between the two, we've already got 8 scored. Faceoff won by the Lumberjacks. Rangers, 12 shots on net. Good for 4 goals. The Lumberjacks, 26 shots on net, good for 4 goals. My take, Rangers need to start firing more. Pepper that goaltender. Prime opportunity here for the visitors. Clutch save by Peterson. Keeps this game tied up at 4 apiece. Cycled back to number 3 of the Lumberjacks. Tied up now along the near side boards. Thrown out front. Number 15 with a one-timer. That is Landon Langenbrunner, a sophomore for the Lumberjacks. Somehow, some way, able to get a stick on it. Wow. That, I was expecting that to sail out of play. I did not think that was going to reach the back of the net. Top shelf it goes, and Forest Lake has gone from a 2-goal lead here in period 2. To now trailing by 1, and yes, that will warrant a timeout. Got a timeout here on the ice, taken by Coach Liu. Back to the drawing board for the Rangers. You are watching Tuesday Ranger Hockey here on Lakes Area Community Television. This is game number 17 on the schedule. 26 games total. Season definitely dwindling down. hasn't been the season that the Rangers have been looking for necessarily. Currently sitting with a record of 3-5-1 in the Suburban East, 4-10-2 overall. Cloquet, they are 3-0 in conference play. Overall, they are 8-5-2. After tonight for the Rangers, it looks like Forest Lake will be on the road at Duluth East. That game, January 24th. That is before returning home on the 28th to host Mountains View and then North St. Paul a few days later on the 31st. So both the Mountains View and North St. Paul game will be held right back here at the Chital Arena, located in the heart of the Forest Lake Sports Center. And of course, we will be here, Lakes Area Community Television, bringing you all of your Forest Lake athletics and more. Faceoff won by the Lumberjacks. Here we go. That's picked up by Gutterman. Played off of the near side. Board sent back into Cloquet territory. Forest Lake desperately trying to get back onto the board, watching a two-goal lead disappear. Now trailing by one. Faceoff will be held at center ice. Won by Forest Lake. Picked up by Robbie, thrown out front. That banks off of the side of the net. Both Saltness and Fink putting in work down there in the corner. Cloquet now with a little bit of room to work with. That's dumped into the Forest Lake zone. Time continues to wind down here in period number two. It has it's been a pretty exciting game. I'd like to see the maroon and gold with a couple more goals here, but cheeky hitting there by number 14 continues his little tantrum out there. That is Zach Conklin, 5'9" junior for the Lumberjacks. Played by the Cloquet goaltender. 2:28 remaining here in period number two. It is Cloquet 5, Forest Lake 4. And that's gloved up by Peterson, resulting in a faceoff inside the Forest Lake zone. Faceoff won by the Lumberjacks, held in by number 22. Shot taken from the high slot. This is wide right. Played off the far side boards. Mulgren with the touch. And ultimately it was number 12, Nick Mulgren, carrying it out to neutral ice. Eventually turned back over to the Lumberjacks, who now have possession inside of the Forest Lake zone. Peterson on his back. That was a scary moment. Back on his feet. And play will be whistled dead. I don't know if the net came off. Nope. Puck is resting on the net. That will do it. Faceoff will remain inside of the Forest Lake zone. Rocky will take the draw for your Rangers. Won by the Lumberjacks, immediately shot on net. Dangerous rebound given up. Puck still sitting out front. That will end up in the back of the net. Just like that, the visitors have a comfortable two-goal lead. I would say that momentum has most definitely shifted. Let's see what Forest Lake can do to get it back. It's amazing how quickly that Forest Lake two-goal lead has shifted to a Lumberjack two-goal lead. Rangers able to respond in period number one. Let's see if they can do it here, or if they're going to come out in period number three firing on all cylinders. Bottom line, this Forest Lake Hockey Club needs a win, especially on home ice with a record of just 2-6 here at Lechette Arena this season. That's what they mean by home ice advantage. You're supposed to have an advantage playing at home. There's an opportunity for Fink. The goaltender for Cloquet well out of his net. Unfortunately, Fink just unable to corral the puck. Lumberjacks back on the tack out in the neutral zone and in Ranger territory. Big hit put on by number 20, Zach Smith of Forest Lake. Doubles up, takes two down. Sent around far side, that should be coming back. That's icing on Forest Lake. Fetch, go get it. It's always fun watching them at the high school level when they flip the puck up to the officials. It doesn't always go as planned, and usually one of the zebras ends up chasing it down at the other end of the ice. They mean well, it's just, you know, it happens. Attempted clear by Government, that's held in at the blue line, and nope, they will not be forced to clear. Tough angled shot taken by number 15, that will be off the side of the net. And period number two is officially in the books. Wow, what a topsy-turvy period this has been. After two, Forest Lake four, Cloquet six. Don't go anywhere, period number three coming up.
Adventure can be found anywhere, but the best place to start is in the forest.
I spy something beginning with S.
Snow?
No.
Snow-covered trees?
Nothing to do with snow.
Head outside to discover incredible animals and beautiful plants that come together to create an unforgettable adventure.
Wow.
So grab your loved ones.
Don't even.
And explore a world of possibilities.
Come on, this way.
Visit discovertheforest.org to find the closest forest or park to you.
Welcome back. Period number three here at Lechette Arena, just about to get underway. It has been quite an eventful two periods, to say the least. We as in us here in Forest Lake, started out trailing by one. Rangers respond with three goals of their own, courtesy of Fink, Saltness, and Anderson to take a two-goal lead. Cloquet comes back with a goal of their own. Forest Lake will respond 4-2. And it has been all Cloquet ever since. Four unanswered goals here by the Lumberjacks has given Okay, a two-goal lead, and that is where we will start out here in period number three. Forest Lake four, Cloquet six. Bottom line, Forest Lake needs to produce more shots on net. play will start out in the force leg zone. And it does not take long for our first whistle here. And it looks like it's courtesy of the net. Again, coming off of its pegs. That has got to be like the biggest problem here at this rink. Can't we invest in some better support strategies for our net? Something. Held in at the blue line by number two. Shot wide right. Forest Lake with just 13 shots on net. Cloquet with 31. And that's what I mean. Forest Lake needs to simply produce more shots on net. They don't necessarily have to be perfect. All you have to do is get it on net and things will happen eventually. Turned over inside of the neutral zone. Lumberjacks with possession. Cross ice pass to number 15. That is Landon Langenbrunner. As that puck checked off of his stick, as Forest Lake will attempt to clear, they do. That's dumped into the Lumberjack zone. Forest Lake will head to the bench to make a change. Back to the blue line. They go tape to tape. That would have been a perfect setup had best played for Cloquet, but right place, right time. Forest Lake will advance to neutral ice. That's dumped into the Lumberjacks zone, played by the goaltender, held in by Soraki. Anderson tries to throw it out front. That's deflected back into the boards. And that one will be coming back. That's nice and on our visitors. Again, you're watching Tuesday Night Ranger Hockey here on Lakes Area Community Television. This is Thomas Glenn. And while we're waiting for this faceoff here in the Cloquet zone, by the way, which Mogren will take the draw. There's a shot on net now. It'll be covered up. We'll have another faceoff inside the Lumberjack zone. I want to remind you, citizens of Forest Lake, don't be afraid to call your local city council and tell them, in order for peace, we must keep our Forest Lake police. I'm sure you have all heard in the headlines recently that our city council would like to disband the entire Forest Lake Police Department, which anyone with common sense knows is just ridiculous. And it's not everybody on the council. There are a couple of members who just had no idea this was going on, but we need to definitely put a stop to this. Played along the near side boards. That's sent around on the far side, and Cloquet will advance outside of the neutral zone. Now forced to regroup. That's dumped into the Ranger zone. Miscommunication on behalf of Forest Lake nearly results in a turnover for the opposition in the offensive zone. Gutterman has a puck checked off of his stick. Trying to figure this out in my head, the way that these two teams have battled back. Forest Lake trailing by two now. If this game was gonna continue with its current trend, by the end of this game, it should be Forest Lake 7, Cloquet 6. But, we'll just have to wait and see. And there's another shot on net that's covered up by Cloquet goaltender. Not a whole lot of action seen by him. Come on, Rangers. Three more goals. Prove science right. Soraki will throw it out front. That's deflected back to the blue line, sent back in by number 17, Drake Best. Picked up along the far side boards. That will allow Cloquet just enough time and space clear, and now currently tied up along the boards, both Kemplin and Soraki. Nope, that is not Soraki, that's Kemplin and I think Robbie fighting for possession. Still tied up and tied up well. That play broken up at center ice. Peterson with the save. We'll have a faceoff inside the Forest Lake zone. Rangers with 17 shots on net. Lumberjacks with 33. Mogren on the draw for your maroon and gold. Won by the visitors back to the blue line. Wrist shot taken, and that is blocked before it has a chance to reach Peterson. Will end up in the bench of Cloquet. Should move the faceoff just outside of the Cloquet zone. Forest Lake running out of time here in period number three. If they're going to stage a comeback, no better time than right now. That one thrown out front, deflected off of one of the defender's sticks. Picked up at the blue line. There's another save by Peterson. That one nearly picked off by Saltness. That would have been looking at a pick six. There you go. Rangers respond and are back on the board. Two-goal lead has been cut by one, and that is number 11, co-captain Zach Robbie. Oh, well, Robbie's just a junior. I don't know why. I thought he was a senior. Good. The entire community of Forest Lake will be glad to hear that. Robbie will be here in Forest Lake for another year. Puck currently tied up behind the Forest Lake goaltender, Peterson. Scoring opportunity here for the visitors. That's deflected wide right. Another dangerous opportunity. Shot taken by number 15. That is Landon Langenbrunner. That is shot right into the chest pads of Peterson. Mogren will take the faceoff for your maroon and gold. Inside the Forest Lake zone, Rangers trailing by one. But like I said, I did my math. And if it holds to be true, the final score will be somehow, someway, Forest Lake 7, Cloquet 6. Let's see if your maroon and gold can make it happen here in period number three. The amount of shots that Forest Lake has been able to create has increased here in the first half of period number three. That's the first step. Need to get back on the board and tie this game up. Now under 9 minutes left to go here in regulation. Turnover in the offensive zone. Looks like we may have a penalty being assessed with 8:46 left to go here in period number three. Please, please be on. It's not looking good unless they're going to hand out coincidentals, making it 4-on-4. To be the case, coincidentals. So are we going to have 4-on-4 or is it 5-on-5? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5-on-5 hockey. Forest Lake with possession inside of their own zone. That's currently tied up along the wall. Played by Gutterman. They picked up inside in the neutral zone. Broken up by number 20, Zach Smith, carried around near side. They'll go back to the blue line. Cloquet team certainly likes to utilize their blue line, which is not a bad game plan. Held in by Best. Forest Lake running out of room here in period number three, trailing by 1 goal. Started out period three trailing 6-4. Goal by Robbie has made it 6-5. Numbers on my paper say it's going to be Forest Lake 7, Cloquet 6. But we all know I have been wrong in the past. I can admit it. No shame in my game. Turned over inside of the neutral zone. Forest Lake with numbers. Held in at the blue line. One timer out front. Soraki to Bartholomew. Rangers almost capitalize on that. Turnover again inside of the neutral zone, but that is broken up just outside of the Forest Lake zone. Dumped into the Forest Lake zone, played by Peterson, picked up by Gutterman behind the Forest Lake net. Rangers now, I was going to say advance to the neutral zone, but that pass was picked off, allowing the Lumberjacks. Oh, you cannot get much closer than that. One little rotation the other way, and that puck could have easily found the back of the net, giving the Lumberjacks a reinstated 2-goal lead, but fortunately, we are able to avoid catastrophe and continue to trail by 1 here in period number 3, under 6 minutes left to go. Forest Lake with 19 shots on net, Cloquet with 35. Puck tied up along the near side wall. eventually popped free, sent back to the blue line, logo tape to tape, looking for the tip out front from Langenbrunner. Oh no. Looks like they're gonna get either Fink or Smith. Taking a minor here, and this is not going to help our cause at all, but you cannot put any of the blame on number 20, Zach Smith. When you're in that position, you got to do what you got to do, and, you know, bottom line, Cloquet did not score. Yes, we have to serve a two-minute minor, but we're not trailing by two, so. That shot high and wide left. That end up in the corner. Forest Lake on the PK here with just a handful of minutes left in period number three. Rangers again trailing by one. There was a huge save by goaltender Peterson. Forest Lake able to clear the zone. Okay, with possession now back in Ranger territory. Puck sent off the near side boards into Lumberjack land. Carried up ice by number 14. Drop pass to 24. Forest Lake with the attempted clear held in by number 7 for the Lumberjacks. Opportunity out front, and that is wasted. Thank you. Wanted the shot, but could not get the puck to lay down flat. And it was either risk a knuckle puck or pass it off. He chose to pass. There's a one-timer. Not the most accurate defensive shooters I've seen. That's for sure. I had a buddy like that. He was actually my defensive partner in high school. I mean, the guy had a rocket for a slap shot, but he could not hit the net to save his life. There goes my number system. Two-goal lead reinstated by the Lumberjacks. That one coming courtesy of number 17, Riggs Olson, 6 foot junior for the Lumberjacks. Forest Lake running out of time here in period number three. That one is deflected off of the skate of number 47, Blake Gunnerman. Why not? Serve another penalty while we're trailing by two here in the third. Twice as many shots taken by Cloquet. And they cling to a two-goal lead here late in period number three. Now on the power play yet again. Hey, buddy. Make sure you stick your head right in front of the camera. Thank you. Face-off inside the Cloquet zone, won by Forest Lake. And the stick blade went 10 times further than the puck. There's a turnover. Robbie with the breakaway, but he forgot his stick. Actually, he didn't forget it. He had it slashed out of his hand, so we should be looking at a two-minute minor being assessed to one of the defensive pairings for Cloquet. Maybe pan the camera back and forth. Fade out. We don't need a close-up of the official and see now plays out of view. That's day one stuff, dude. Come on. Possession picked back up inside of the neutral zone. Offsides on the Lumberjacks. Going to bring the faceoff just outside of the Forest Lake zone. Or not, that's going to bring the faceoff to center ice. Lumberjacks with possession. Clock continues to wind down here in regulation at Lichita Arena. Game number 17 here for your Rangers. This is game number 16 for the visitors. What a one-time setup. And Robbie will pick up goal number two here tonight. Rangers are now within one. Faceoff won by the Rangers, picked up by Saltness. Back on the attack. That is dumped into the Forest Lake zone. Carried up by Miller, possession lost. Okay, now with the puck inside of their own zone. See if Forest Lake will pull their goaltender here, trailing by one. Looks like they wanted to there, but possession was turned over. Opportunity for the Rangers to tie this up. Siraki. Forest Lake with an extra skater. Peterson removed from the net. Best will throw it out front. Nothing there. That's deflected back into the corner. Fink. And again, that takes a deflection off of the skates. And unfortunately, Forest Lake will just run out of time as the clock winds down to zero. Very, very frustrating loss here for the Rangers, giving up 2-3-4 leads in the process. There you go. That's the final score after three periods played. Final score is Cloquet Esko Carlton 7, Forest Lake 6. You have been watching Tuesday Night Ranger Hockey here on Lakes Area Community Television. Coming up next, Forest Lake will be on the road at Duluth East January 24th. Before returning home here at the Forest Lake Sports Center on the 28th to host Moundsview. and then North St. Paul just a few days later on the 31st. Both games right here and available on Lakes Area Community Television. This is Thomas Glenn. Have a good night.